You've had your fun. I'll give you one more chance. And if you don't clear out now, there'll be real trouble. I mean it.
This is David Sumner. All his life, he's been running away, turning his back on trouble, involvement, and confrontation. Until now.
There are 5 men out there.
I know that.
He took his wife and fled to an English country town.
There was once a time, Mrs. Sumner, when you were ready to beg me for it.
Take your hands off me.
What are you doing?
An animal. He thought he could find peace and refuge. Instead, he found that a man can't hide forever.
I care. This is where I live.
No!
I will not allow violence against this house.
Sam Peckinpah, who uncaged the Wild Bunch, now unleashes Dustin Hoffman in Straw Dogs.
3:34 p.m. Unidentified male, Caucasian.
House Internal Security Committee surveillance, AD 271T41.
Internal Revenue Service surveillance, Pat Angelo. Case 642DZ713.
Someone is listening. Someone is watching.
July 16th, 4:45 p.m.
What sort of people live here?
Oh, we have a variety. There's a fag decorator upstairs and a doctor downstairs, although they say he's an abortionist. They're all loaded.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to back up a moving van and then steal the guts out of the whole place.
I need you to bridge some burglar alarms, open doors, cut some telephone circuits.
I got a job laid out.
Need a good driver with a cool head.
I want schedules of services. I want hours and names of maids, doormen, janitor, the works.
Come to decorate your halls.
And not a moment too soon.
What do you think?
I think it stinks. What are we screwing around with stuff like this? Even if he scores, it's less than 1 week's taking our worst horse groom.
Someone is listening. Someone is watching.
This guy's moving a muscle. He's got every move laid out. It's like a military operation.
You okayed the deal. We give you the money for the finance. We want 64.
Everyone knows it's an improbable crime. Yet Duke Anderson may pull off the impossible.
Yes?
Oh, what the hell is this?
Mrs. Hathaway!
Oh, for God's sake, shut up. It's a robbery!
The bestseller that bugged the world of crime unreels its power on the screen.
Back you!
One day, a professional killer went home to visit his family and found his brother murdered.
Now, who killed him?
I don't know nothing.
Now listen, the only reason I came back to this crap house was to find out who did it. And I'm not leaving till I do.
Michael Caine is Carter, a man with unbridled hate.
Do you want to be dead, Albert?
For Christ's sake! You knew what I'd do, didn't you, Albert? Listen,
Christ, I didn't kill him.
I know you did.
When a professional killer hates, he turns animal. And there becomes but one law in the underworld jungle. Get Carter. Get Carter. Before Carter gets you.
Don't let us interrupt you. Now,
don't you think you ought to get dressed first? Come on, Jack, put it away. You know you won't use it.
The gun he means. Out.
Carter, the heated killer, the cool lover. Carter, a man of few words, a man of decisive action.
I've come for you, Margaret.
Take your clothes off.
Few words. Decisive action. Hate drives the hunter.
No! No!
Fear pursues the hunted.
They have killed me! They killed my brother! He's dead! Hey! Stay.
Carter, spreading terror with an uncontrolled trigger. Carter was a killer by profession. Now he is a killer by instinct.
Goodbye!
Michael Caine is Carter. Get Carter before Carter gets you.
Supercharged Dodge Challenger from Denver to San Francisco. Background, Medal of Honor in Vietnam. Former stock and bike racer. Former cop, dishonorably discharged. Now he uses speed to get himself up, to get himself gone. Everybody's after Kowalski.
Because you think we're queers.
For one reason or another.
Is there something I can do for you?
Well, like what?
Like anything you want.
Everybody wants a piece of his hide.
Maybe kill somebody. Maybe stole that big dude of his. Maybe both.
I think that son of a...
They want to get him and put him away. But they'll have to catch him first.
Ah, that's my own info! This is yours truly, Super Duper Soul! Directed live transmission from K-O-W! With the wham, bam, boom, boom, wake up music!
And there goes the challenger, being chased by the blue meanies on wheels. The vicious traffic squad cars are after our known driver. The super driver of the Golden West. The police numbers are getting closer to our sole hero in his sole mobile. They're gonna get him, smash him, rip the last American hero.
It's the maximum trip at maximum speed. Vanishing point.
I'm Abel Morris, Chief of Police. I've got a court order here.
James Garner, police chief of a small town, and it's his first murder case.
Local resident dies after attack by crazed dog.
You were right to dig her up. The inquest was wrong. She didn't bleed to death, she drowned.
The evidence. The odor of gasoline in a bathtub. And a 12-year-old bottle of scotch.
Where's that bottle?
Here it is. I missed.
The scene of the crime. And who did away with it?
Come back here! Come on!
Just when he thinks he has the killer, the mystery really begins.
She told me she was leaving me for another woman. What was she hiding?
That's all you guys think about.
Hey, hey, let's get down.
Would you excuse me for a minute?
He pursues the most unusual lineup of suspects ever assembled in the most bizarre murder mystery of the year.
If you drink it, Ernie, you'll die.
He's right.
I want you to tell me how you knew his name was Murphy, and you tell me now. Tell me now!
Leave it to James Garner to wind up in bed with his two prime suspects, a girl and a dog named Murphy.
Why can't stop?
Anyone in town could be the killer. Was it the veterinarian, the state trooper, the wife, the sergeant, the playboy, the shopkeeper, the counterman, the secretary? James Garner and Catherine Ross star in They Only Kill Their Masters.
Where are you going, city boy?
We'll find it.
It ain't nothing but the biggest river in the state.
These are the men. Nothing very unusual about them. Suburban guys like you or your neighbor. Nothing very unusual about them until they decided to spend one weekend canoeing down the Cahoolawasee River. Ed Gentry, he runs an art service. Wife Martha has a boy, Dean. Louis Medlock has real estate interests, talks about resettling in New Zealand or Uruguay. Drew Ballinger, he's sales supervisor for a soft drink company. Bobby Tripp, bachelor, insurance and mutual funds.
Where you going?
All right, I'm looking.
These are the men who decided not to play golf that weekend. Instead, they sought the river.
Would you like to check it?
Out there anywhere watching us right now. We ain't gonna be so made not hard to follow dragging a corpse.
Louis, I'm gonna pull off to the side. There's something wrong.
No, go on!
John Boorman's film of James Dickey's explosive best-selling novel.
They say seeing is believing, but only a split second of time separates the past from the future. The present is crushed between them. A thin thread of life in a skein of death.
Laura!
Looking at?
I don't know what's happening.
You are warned. Things are not what they seem. Don't look now.
What is it, Mr. Baxter? What is it you fear?
Find him.
You must find him.
You must try to get him back.
It was a warning. It was Christine. She was trying to warn us. Your life is in danger while you're in Venice.
What is it you fear?
Christine is dead. She is dead.
Did she die suddenly?
Laura! Laura!
John, I wish you'd believe me.
She is dead!
You must find him!
Dead!
You are warned. Things are not what they seem. Don't look now.
This is a world of hidden mics and two-way mirrors. A world where nothing is private.
You think we can do this?
Later in the week.
You think we can do this?
Harry Call is an expert. The best there is.
Let me tell you something about Harry Call. The best bar none. I'll drink to that.
Best what?
The best bugger on the West Coast.
What about me?
He can bug anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Nobody knows how you did it, though, Harry. It caused a hell of a scandal, too.
Look, do you see him? The man with the hearing aid, like Charles. He's been following us all.
They're not people to him, just voices.
Three people were murdered, that's all.
He doesn't know them, and they don't know him.
Had nothing to do with me. I mean, I just turned in the tapes. Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. I've been involved in some work that I think will be used
you
to hurt these two young people. No way responsible. I'm not responsible.
You're not supposed to feel anything about it. You're just supposed to do it.
Be careful, Harry. You're just supposed to listen. Not look. Not feel. Not care.
Yes. How'd you get this phone number?
We prepare a full dossier on everyone.
It's terrific. The bugger got fucked, huh?
Do you have secrets, Harry? I know you do. Tell me about yourself. Your secrets.
I don't have any secrets. Don't get involved in this, Mr. Cole. These tapes are dangerous.
Come on, Harry. Show and tell. How do you do it?
Why are you asking all these questions?
Gene Hackman is Harry Call in The Conversation. There is nothing private about The Conversation. Listen.
My name is Harry Call. Can you hear me?
Mike Locken and George Hansen are friends.
They share just about everything.
Hey, give me $100. Yeah, well, what can you do with this stuff now? It's Monopoly money.
The same apartment.
I got a shower and shave, man.
Here's your juice. You can shower there.
The same women.
What do you think of that little chick you just left in bed?
Very nice.
They even share the same job. They work for the CIA. They're part of the killer elite. James Caan and Robert Duvall. In Sam Peckinpah's The Killer Elite, a very private enterprise that employs cab drivers.
I used to think what I did was nice and necessary. What the hell do I know?
Pretty girls, sportsmen.
I got me tapped as a psycho.
Executives.
The CIA gives us 11% of our gross.
Everybody get back.
That's plastique with a detonator.
What should I do with it?
See that bay right there? I'd run down there and chuck it in there. Listen, officer, I'd sure run.
What a dummy.
James Caan is locking. He was the best until he was broken.
You're a cripple. You'll never be Top Gun again.
Then he became even better.
I'm coming back full duty.
Robert Duvall is Hanson. They were close.
Are you part of the organization?
But not close enough.
You just retired, Mike. Enjoyed it. A guy can't blow up his best friend. Where's the morality in the world?
If it hadn't been me, it would have been somebody else.
Everybody pays you, don't they?
Well, we're all idealists.
James Caan. Robert Duvall. Arthur Hill. Gig Young. The Killer Elite.
That eerie sensation that you've seen a stranger before. Everyone's experienced it. Call it deja vu. This man calls it terror. Master filmmaker Brian De Palma now creates obsession. Michael Cortland has denied a nightmare for 16 years. Now that nightmare will have its revenge.
What was she like?
Elizabeth. She was very much like you.
How did she die?
I killed her.
Cliff Robertson. Jean-Pierre Bougeau.
I am Elizabeth. I came to give you a second chance to prove your love.
An act of love in its ultimate state becomes the ultimate in suspense. Obsession.
Kill them, we'll probably want to speak to you.
I don't know anything.
And I'd like to use you as possible bait.
Help! Help!
It's not safe.
Help!
Is it safe?
Is it safe?
No, it's not safe. It's very dangerous.
Probably the wealthiest and most wanted Nazi left alive.
I'm positive your brother meant to rob me when I leave the bank with my diamonds.
Oh, I don't know anything.
Well, can I trust you?
You never could.
You're uncontrollable. What you offer us is valuable, but it's not worth the chaos you're causing.
Where is he?
No!
Now, when the gap gets too large between what the FBI can handle effectively and what the CIA doesn't want to deal with, that's where we come in.
What do you do exactly?
We provide.
Provide what?
Anything.
Were you Sal's mistress?
I never even met him.
Is it safe?
Marathon Man.
Where is the patient?
Coming right down, Dr. Collins.
You enter a major metropolitan hospital for routine surgery.
What's the matter?
I don't know.
Something goes wrong.
She never woke up.
No.
What if it wasn't an accident? Now, the number one best-selling mystery becomes the most thrilling suspense film of the year. Javier Bugeaud is Dr. Susan Wheeler.
Been about a dozen of these coma cases here in the last year. They're always different. Hard to imagine it's murder.
Are you sure?
Susan, what do you think? There's a conspiracy at the Boston Memorial Hospital?
I'm fine. I don't need a shrink.
But I think it's important to have on the record.
She's under stress, a little paranoid.
Well, she thinks there's a conspiracy.
Does she think you're involved?
Michael Douglas is Dr. Mark Bellows.
No, I don't think so.
First rule of crime. Keep it simple.
Somebody is putting people into comas. They're murdering them.
It's a 4367. The bidding now stands at 42.5. A 31-year-old male.
At Boston Memorial Hospital, only one doctor can save your life. But first, she's got to save her own.
Susan!
We have to do something. This is real, Mark.
Somebody's seen too much.
What's the matter?
I don't know what the matter is.
Somebody's gone too far. Somebody's getting away with murder.
History has shown how one man with a dream can turn the world into a nightmare. Can history repeat itself? The Boys from Brazil starts where that nightmare left off. But for the dream to live again, 94 men must die. Gregory Peck is the architect of that dream. Laurence Olivier is the man who must destroy it before it destroys the world.
He betrayed you! He betrayed the Aryan race!
Tell you who the boys from Brazil are, only that they are not science fiction.
30 years the world has forgotten, and you persist and persist.
Well, not the guards now, madame.
You are prisoner!
The time is the present. The people exist. The threat is real.
Your operation has been canceled.
No. Your operation has been canceled. Mine continues.
Barry is dead.
Herr Liebermann.
Only you can decide if it's a dream or a nightmare. But be warned, if history can repeat itself, so can man.
A total of 94 assassinations.
Look for the boys from Brazil before they look for you.
The China Syndrome. It's about people. People who lie. And people faced with the agony of telling the truth.
Right.
People like Kimberly Wells, a television reporter paid to smile, not to think.
A few words about a veterinarian who makes house calls on sick fish. Or is it aquarium calls?
Richard Adams, a cameraman who never learned how to play by the rules.
Wait till you get that other room, get that radiation all over that cute little body.
Jack Goodell, an engineer who knows too much to tell the truth.
In anything that man ever does, there's some element of risk, right? Well, that's why we have what we call defense in depth.
And cares too much to lie.
No accident.
It will start with a tremor in a nuclear power plant. Where it will end will depend on three people.
I would say you're probably lucky to be alive. Same for the rest of Southern California.
Jane Fonda.
Let's face it, you didn't get this job because of your investigative abilities. Kimberly, don't fight it.
Jack Lemmon.
There was a vibration.
Michael Douglas.
I don't know that accident is the right word.
Accident is the right word.
The China Syndrome. The harder they try, the more resistance they meet.
They've got their own security man. Do you hear what I'm saying? Do you want me to make it any clearer?
The closer they get, the more threatening it becomes. The China Syndrome. Today, only a handful of people know what it really means. And they're scared.
Everybody keep your station! Everybody keep your station!
Soon, you will know. The China Syndrome.